Hello and welcome to Wingin' It. So we are back here with another gameplay video. This is game 2 of the Wingspan Open second round match against Volzy Man. So yeah, if you haven't seen the first part already, I definitely recommend you go check that one out first. Just to spoil the result, we did win that one. So it's a best of 5, however, in this Wingspan Open. So we are far from getting through in this series so far. So yeah, we went second in game 1, which means we get to go first here. In game 2, so let's have a look at the starting hand. And all things considered, not too bad, I think. Purple Martin, you always like to see that, so that's going to be, I think, an instant keep. And likewise, Ecologist, very good bonus card there to go with this Martin. But not really a whole lot else. Not really a whole lot else, if I'm completely honest. So it might just have to be Purple Martin and a little bit of digging. So yeah, feeder is not looking great. Feeder's definitely not looking great. So as tempting as it might be ordinarily to go for that Clark's Nutcracker, might be a bit tricky to get that one down. So yeah, it might just have to be Martin. I mean, I like to put the Martin in the grass and lay eggs a few times and kind of see what you get, but definitely tricky here when you don't have so many egg spots. You find yourself maybe having to put it in the wetlands and use that to dig a bit. So yeah, difficult decision here. I want to keep an extra card at least to tuck with, and then maybe I can go for that woodpecker as well, and then that can be my wetland bird. I can always grab the worm that's the feeder, play that in the wetlands. It's not terrible, but it's definitely not great, so I think we'll go with that. Because yeah, really gonna prioritize the wetlands here, prioritize getting something there, start drawing some cards. I think it's always better to get the wetlands going first, let yourself see some cards, and then hopefully you can use that to find some good forest birds. So we'll keep the Nutcracker because there's no way I'm playing this. At least keep something I might play and go from there. So yeah, not super amazing, but definitely a bird like the Martin, like to have that in the starting hand for sure. Yeah, it's going to be the question of where do I put it. That's going to be the tricky decision. So I don't think it's obvious here. Like I say, I like to put it in the grasslands and just dig for a bit. Use the card cycle ability on this Purple Martin tuck, whatever I've got. So in this case, the Nutcracker, and then look at drawing either something from the tray if something good comes up, or just dig a bit from the deck and hopefully find something better. So yeah, I think at the very least, I think I will take the worm on that first turn. Then, like I say, I'm very tempted to go grass and Martin, lay eggs, get that red-headed woodpecker, and then even if I can't use that ability, so it is a food gaining power, but you need the right food in the bird feeder to be able to use that. So what have they done? At most standard start in Wingspan, two birds and cherry seed worm. So let's grab the worm and go from there. I think nothing super amazing in the tray that, yeah, when you go first, you kind of hope you would see something good. But it does mean, yeah, I don't think I need to worry too much about grabbing any of those. I suppose they might be tempted by taking that sparrow. And yeah, it could be something, you know, if I went grass and sparrow, wetland Martin. It's not a bad little duo there, as a way of yeah, getting some extra eggs with the sparrow and then discard those, get cards, cycle with the Martin. That could be an option. See what they're doing. Rosebush of Grosbeak, definitely a good power to be going for early on in the forest. We're gonna go grass and Martin here. And I'm kind of hoping with this Grosbeak, kind of hoping they might cycle the feeder a bit. And if they do, and I can use that woodpecker and You know, sometimes just that one seed is all you need. You know, you get something like a nuthatcher, a chickadee, some kind of cheap forest birds, get a seed with the woodpecker, and then you can play it, and you're away. So, yeah, that might be an option to go for. But there we go. See, they're already resetting the feeder or putting it in a position to reroll. So, I think we're going to go with this plan. Hopefully, nothing good is going to get revealed. I mean, that is definitely good for this turn. So, if that is still there, I probably do grab that, but yeah, it depends a lot on what their second bird is that they kept in their starting hand. Because if it's not a wetland bird, I would imagine, yeah, I'd imagine they're going to grab that force attack, because that's a pretty good one. They're not going for it though. They are not going for it. So we have a decision to make now. I think I'm going to take that force's turn. And play that, and then maybe this woodpecker, maybe that can be my forest bird, but definitely force's turn. I think that's going to be a good way to let myself see some extra cards and go from there. So yeah, kind of interesting they're going for food so much. Maybe it's just an expensive wetland bird, or maybe it's a white stork. Oh no, it's a Wilson snipe. Okay. That's fine. That is fine. So that's going to help me a little bit in giving some extra cards. And I might... Yeah, I'm gonna hold off on the turn for now. Because I'm going to expect that they're going to give me a free card. And if they do that, I can... still have something to tuck with the Martin, so we are going to go forest. We're going to go forest woodpecker here. I can gain that fish that's there, and then think about hoping for a seed on the reroll. So, yeah, I think they will use the sniper. I think they're going to lay eggs, use the snipe. Okay, so that makes sense why they went for food twice, because there wasn't a worm the first time. They had to go twice to get the worm. They did want to overpay. Got it. What did they just take? There was something there. But there we go, free card already. They didn't even bother. They didn't even bother laying eggs. They just went and straight away gave you the free card. So don't want that at all. Do I want that Gallinule? I kind of might want that Gallinule. Looking at that last end of round goal, definitely fits. So yeah, it's better than this force's turn, I think. And I can potentially, if I discard this Cassim's Finch, I can potentially get all the food for that in a single turn. So we're going to do that. Ultimate Oriole, another nice reveal. Oh, I'm annoyed that I can't remember. this is one of those tips that I always tell other people. Pay attention to the tray so that you see what your opponent's taking. So yeah, say is, what is it? Do as I say, not as I do. pay attention to the tray. And you'll know a little bit more information about what's in your opponent's hand and what they might be playing. So, yeah. Oh well. Was it the sparrow? Maybe it was the grasshopper sparrow, which would make sense if they want to play that. Get some eggs for this end around. It was the grasshopper sparrow. There we go. See, I am sort of paying attention. I am sort of paying attention. But yeah, we'll get rid of the Cassim's Finch, and hopefully. That's a big shame. That is a big shame. Yeah, we really needed that seed, and the feeder is left in such an awful state. We can't even re-roll and hope to get a seed from that, so that's very annoying. But what can you do? Sometimes Wingspan is a game of fine margins, and sometimes one little thing like that can change your fortunes. It's something that I've talked about before with the Bee Eater, one of those powers where you play early and you rely on those free worms from the bird feeder to get you going. And yeah, I think there was a big reliance on that woodpecker working, and it's not done the business for me there, which is a shame. And yeah, I can't really necessarily see them getting food anytime soon. I think they're just gonna lay eggs and then don't know, probably go for cards again and see what they can get. Because you want to see cards. You want to see cards before you get food. That is kind of important, so. But yeah, man. That missing seed. Definitely annoying. So have they laid eggs? They have laid eggs. I might just take that cherry. Because then if they want to use that grosbeak power, they are gonna have to re-roll. And I want them to be re-rolling so that I can get the food for this Galanyor. So it's a bit slow. It's a bit slow. But we're winning this end of round. That's the main thing. We've got, yes, a couple of good birds down, and definitely I think this Galanyor, hoping we can get that down. But yeah, I'm hoping they can give us a free card here. So then even if they don't reroll the bird feeder, we can at least chuck a card, get two food, reroll. And like I say, hope again that we can get that seed on the reroll, because we're going to need it. We're going to need it if we're going to try and get this Galanyor down. So yeah, what are they going to do? Are they going to draw cards or are they just going to lay eggs again? Wait for the fresh tray. Certainly wouldn't blame them for doing that, just being a bit patient. Because I think they've only got one card in hand from the snipe. So they can't... I suppose they could go for food and discard that, but... might not be something you'd want to do in this situation. Yeah, we're gonna have to think. We have to think a little bit about the next end around. God, I don't like having the white and no powers that early on, because normally you don't play white power birds so early in the game. I did have that Cassin's Finch. I could have kept it, but I had to risk it there and again go for that seed, which didn't come through. But yeah, we might be able to get one. But here we go. We do get a free card from the snipe. I think I saw a Carolina Wren in the tray, which would be a nice white and no power bird to go for. I'd imagine they're going to grab that because they can play it straight away as well. Second forest bird. Definitely nice to get yourself going. So yeah, that's kind of the exception, I suppose. Birds like the Wren and the Stilt, Brant. You know, even something like Condor, I suppose. You might play that early as well. Those are the kind of white power birds, but yeah. Most of those big point birds like Puffin, you're not really going to play those, but they have not gone for the Wren because they have got the Ordwin's Gull. So that's a really nice one for them. I imagine they're going to be using that quite a bit. But then maybe that means they keep using this snipe and we keep tucking. I don't mind that at all. So let's use the tucking power to our advantage. And yeah, I think we are going to go for this Carolina Wren. That kind of hits this end around goal, gives us loads of egg space. For the next end of round goal as well. So it works for two of those. Gives us a couple more cards. Gives us two food access in the forest. Lots of good reasons, I think, to be going for this Carolina Wren. So they took... I was paying attention at the time. It's the Great Tit and the Peregrine Falcon. So yeah, maybe they've got their eye on the two rodents as a way of getting that Falcon down. It's certainly not a bad one. Certainly not a bad grass and bird to add to the Sparrow that they have got going on here. So hoping we get another free card. As I say, definitely not going to say no. The fewer turns I can use my wetlands here, if I can just focus on tucking in the grasslands, I'm going to be very happy with that. So yeah, more free cards, please. More free cards. That's definitely what I want to see. No free cards, but we got a spotted owl in the tray. And I might grab that. I'm not super keen on the Song Sparrow. Black Throat Diver's actually quite good. But yeah, spotted owl, I think I'll take that. At the very least, stop them. But also, I might be able to play that as well for this end of round. Not too worried about that Hooded Crow. But yeah, we're doing okay. Considering we've got no wetlands, making the most of these snipe cards. But we do have some good wetlands options up our sleeve, so that's going to be quite nice. Definitely going to be nice. I think they're going to have to start going for food and focusing on getting some of their own birds down, but I think we're in a good position here. But they certainly don't have a bad setup. They've got a lot of card access. Grosbeak is good. Grasshopper Sparrow as well is good. And like I say, that Peregrine Falcon's going to be nice. And yeah, the Great Tit. I think the Great Tit's got a lot of egg space as well, so that might be something to watch out for next in a round goal. But we will start getting some food. And hopefully this time, there we go, much better, from the woodpecker. So yeah, I think they're going to have to go for food again if they want to start playing some of these extra birds they've got. And I'm hoping they can leave that rodent for me, because yeah, I imagine... Oh, Carolina Chickadee. Okay, so they are going to go for food again now, I think. But I want to get this Galenial down. I think that's a really good bird for me to play. Lots of points, lots of egg space. Definitely that last in a round goal as well is going to be good. So we'll play it. And yeah. Still gives me enough turns where I can go for food and play this spotted owl. And yeah. See what the bonus card is, but... more importantly, definitely secure the end of round. To be honest, I don't think they've got enough turns. Go for food here, makes sense, but they haven't got eggs. They have to lay eggs and then play something, so we'll see what that something is. But do we take the fish here for the diver? I think we do. Hopefully a rat on the reroll, excellent, and we even get a seed as well, so we're looking good. We can play both these birds, set ourselves up with a really nice wetlands going into the next round. And who knows, maybe we're not going to need to draw cards too many times, because if we've got four cards in this wetlands, that's going to be super nice. So there we go, they have laid eggs. And yeah, we'll play the diver first. We'll play the diver first, because we might not need to play the owl yet, but it's nice to have the option. Yeah, that diver's going to be good. And yeah, I think actually having three birds in the forest, this is a point I like to make, is that when you've got good card access, having an odd number of forest birds is important, because you get the option of discarding. So right now, you know, I get two food and then a third maybe from the woodpecker. If I play the spotted owl, I can get an extra food by discarding cards, and yeah, with the amount of cards I'm going to be seeing, and with this snipe as well potentially giving me even more cards, I want that option of getting extra food. You know, I want more food so I can play more birds. That's going to be important. Definitely important. So, especially with this ecologist, I'm hoping for three columns. Hoping for three columns minimum. Get those 6 points. That's a strong score to get. So, I was thinking, is it going to be a house wren or a bluebird or something? So, they're on the board for send around, but we're going to sneak ahead with the owl. And what bonus cards are we going to get? Very, very nice ones indeed. Ethologist or omnivore? Ooh, I might go omnivore here. I think ethologist, that's normally the best one, I think, to see in the middle of the game, because you're guaranteed two. Like here, again, you're easily getting four without really even trying. How likely am I to add a pink or a teal into that forest? Not very. I think I'm more likely to find more omnivore birds, so we'll go with that. But yeah, 4 points off that is already pretty tasty. And I think I can see a very nice, tasty-looking bird in the trait as well. Eastern Imperial Eagle. And even that Nightingale, I like that as well. So we're going to take both of these. Yoink. Reset the tray. Yoink. There's the omnivore bird. Yeah, we will use the Galenule as well. There's another omnivore bird. Wow. Have you ever seen a turn quite like that, drawing so many crazy birds? But yeah, I don't think I'll need the Mute Swan. Not with the White Stork in play, but yeah, White Stork, Nightingale, and Martin in the Grasslands. I think that's me set, and that's the power of that card draw. That's exactly what I was saying. Get the Wellerbeds down, get yourself set up, knowing that you're going first. Some of these trays, they can be game-changing. Like the first round tray was terrible, but even in round three and even in round four, you can still get these kind of trays. So, kind of goes without saying that that was a very good pick. And we're still getting more free cards as well that we like. So yeah, let's go for food. We've got a fish already here. We hopefully will get some worms. There we go, there's one. And yeah, we will take the seed, and then we can play both these two grass and birds, the stork and the nightingale, and then I think we just lay eggs. I think we just lay eggs twice. We can really try and max this end of round goal as much as possible with the good Grasson's egg laying that we're going to be doing. So yeah, this is going well. This is going well, kind of goes without saying, but always happy to see birds like this. And yeah, the bonus cards are looking good as well. I think Ecologist should be able to hit six on that. And yeah, Nightingale's going to get us food. White Stork's going to get us cards. And the egg action in the Grasslands is going to get us the egg. So that's all we need. That's all we need to be, keeping ourselves busy in this game. Getting eggs, cards, and food all at the same time. So yeah, very, very nice indeed. Very nice. But I think our opponent, I think they're doing well as well. I don't think they're struggling as much as they certainly could have been, maybe given. Okay, they've got food. Yeah, maybe I think given the slightly slow development in the forest, maybe getting the food was a bit of a problem. But the chickadee, this is a good two bird forest. And yeah, I'll be interested to see if they do play this this great tip that we know they have got, because I think that could win them the end of round. But we're going to play these birds. So I think we want to play the nightingale first, because if we get a good card with the stork, we can then pick the correct food that we want with that nightingale. So let's get the nightingale down. Make sure we leave the eggs in the forest. And yeah, we can play the stork. So that leaves us one egg in the forest. We lay eggs twice. That gets us seven. But we do have space for more, so chucking food is an option. But we'll see. We'll play it by ear. We'll play it by ear, dependent on what our opponent does in terms of the forest birds. But yeah, something like a great tip. If it gets you a 6-point swing, if it takes you from losing to winning an end round goal, then it's worth it. I think it's still worth it, even at this point of the game. But yeah, their Grasslands is good. I think they can still safely hammer that Grasslands. They're going to get some free food from me, so maybe the forest doesn't need any more action. They can focus on just laying eggs. And yeah, using this really nice wetlands to get some extra cards should they need it. But it's time to get the stork down. Very, very nice. Hitting omnivore. So yeah, glad I kept that. Definitely glad I kept that. Lots of points on the board. Yeah, this meat swarm, we might still play it. If we don't find a better wetland bird, it hits both our bonus cards. So even though it's only 4 points, we're going to get another 4 from bonus cards. So not bad at all. Not bad at all. Okay, so they're getting food. Maybe they can still play. If they play a forest bird, they lose an egg. They lay eggs, they can get another 5. So they can get to 9, in theory, if they have space. Do we want to worry about competing with that? I think it might be worthwhile. We'll chuck the food this turn at least. We'll chuck the food for this turn. Blue and Warbler, pretty nice. Pretty nice. So we'll take a worm. Do we get rid of the swan? I think we do. I think we can find something better. I think with this white stalk, even just a few activations, we should be able to find something good. But yeah, we'll see. I think they might still play this great tip. I think they might. And if they do, I think tying this end around goal, it's going to be worth it, because we're getting the extra eggs and we're getting three 3 more from tying the end around goal, so. Oh, Barrow's golden, okay. Didn't need to discard the food, but that's a really good one for them to get some free eggs from me, so. Yeah, we're okay on the end around. We don't need to discard any more food. Because, yeah, they can only get 2 more. So we'll put... they can only get 6. So we'll put ourselves on 7, and we'll start filling up these platform nests ready for the next end around. So another warbler. Well, that one goes in the wetland, so probably we'll go for that one over blue winged. And yeah, otherwise we just need some cards. We just need to pick up some cards with this white stork, because we're going to want to pay for this East Imperial Eagle. And that's going to get a lot of free points. A lot of free points. No food. And when I'm running a low food setup like this, that's just such a good bird to be having. I mean, these are already good birds. You're always happy to see these. I think this is where Mother Love's kind of philosophy comes into play, which is eagles are always good to play. It's so rare that you run into a situation where it's not worth playing these. So, Owl's Finch, well, they've got a good grass, and they've got a really, really solid grass and here for this end game. They're going to score a lot of points there. So yeah, that's going to bring them back into it a little bit. And of course, as I say, this Goldeneye with some free eggs as well. But yeah, how are they looking in around? They've got two platform nests. We are going to have 8. So I think we're going to be okay. But who knows? They might have some nice wetland birds to play. Score a lot of points. So let's keep filling these up. We'll take that, because that might come into play for their end of rounds. And you know what? We'll take that as well. We'll just block all of the platform nests. But yeah, now I think our last 4 turns, I think we play these 2 birds. We just lay eggs. Lay eggs 2 turns. Get 5 points a turn. Obviously not as good as their engine. And we give a point to them, so... Playing birds is good. Playing birds is good. But yeah, I reckon they probably do have at least one more bird to play. Not really sure what that could be. But we'll see. We'll see what it's going to be. Maybe they might go for food once more. But otherwise, I think this engine's so good. And they do have egg space. They've got 15 spaces. They lay 5 eggs a turn. Well, actually, I suppose if they get a couple of free eggs from us, that might change their mind. But yeah, we'll play Eastern Imperial. Tuck away these 3. It's tempting to play the Magpie, because it would get me some Omnivore Expert points and also the Teal Power, but I don't think it's worth it at this point. So yeah, Eagle's going down. There we go. Very nice. Very nice. 8 points for 0 foods. Good play at the end of the game. And yeah, I think we'll lay eggs. We'll lay eggs before we play the Warbler. Because who knows, we might find a Puffin or something that we want to play. Or like a Woodstalk or something. So, like the Meat Swan before, it's going to hit both bonus cards. So that would be the dream. But otherwise, yeah. Good to have this as a backup option for 8 points. I'm not going to complain. Not going to complain having this Warbler something to play. So there we go. White-faced Ibis, not a bad little bird. That's their egg space sorted. So it's not going to win them the end of round. We have that in the bag. Greater Roadrunner. It's an omnivore bird, but it doesn't hit ecologists. So it's still less points. And it costs more eggs. So not interested. Bald Eagle would be interesting, but I don't think I have the turns to get the food for that. Unfortunately, but yeah, we'll do one more pass. One more pass on the grasslands, and then we'll play this warbler. So, all things considered, it's gone pretty well. Pretty smooth running this game. Definitely an uncertain start, but that's why I like to play the Martin in the grasslands, because if you can get through that early game where it might be a bit of a struggle not having the card access, especially if your opponent's going to give you free cards with something like the snipe, you know, having that in the grasslands for the late game is just so powerful with the point scoring and the card cycle. Definitely a good bet to have there. So we'll lay eggs, we'll see what we get. Fine, not anything amazing. We'll tuck you. And yeah, we've still got this warbler, so we can play that, and it's going to be a very strong score. It's going to be in the triple digits. It might be into the 110. So that's the power of the White Stork. That's the power of the Eastern Imperial Eagle, and that is the power of having some good bonus cards. And I think we're going to win all the end of round goals as well. So yeah, that's so hard. That's another thing I talk about a lot, these end of round goals. You know, if you lose all four, so difficult to fight against that, because you're just giving so many points away to your opponent. It's 22 points to 10 in end of round goals. It's a big deficit to fight back from. So there we go, win the end of round goal, and we go into the final score. So yeah, I think this is going to be a comfortable win here. Should be a good number of points on birds. It is indeed, and of course, two very strong bonus cards as well. And here we go, end of round points. As I say, 22 to 10. Very commanding position there. I think we both have got a lot of eggs, so they'll drag it back a little bit. Food on cards, not too many, but of course, we do have quite a few tuck cards. And we do get into the 110s. It's a final score of 111. And our opponent in the end on 90. So we'll take a look at their bonus cards. Falconer, not bad, and certainly the Ibis at the end. And that Peregrine Falcon as well explains why they went for that. But yeah, definitely a case of us having a very nice round three tray, very fortunate round three tray, and of course getting that White Stork, activating the Dipper. Kind of all fell into place. It was one of those where I think I already had a strong setup. I think I was already in a good position to win the game. But yeah, getting the Nightingale and the Stork to kind of flesh out the grasslands a bit, and of course that Eastern Imperial Eagle, very, very nice indeed to get down at the end. So yeah, that was a good game. Thank you for watching. We're not through. Even with two wins, as I said, best of five in this Wingspan Open. So we do have at least one more to get ourselves into the next round. So stay tuned for that. And if you're not subscribed, please do. You'll get notified when those future parts come out. But otherwise, yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.